In the Democratic Republic of Congo, around 3 million people have been forced out of their homes. Some live with host families, some in camps, while others hide in the bush. Many of the displaced have dropped out of sight and are thus deprived of state-provided services and humanitarian aid. Augustine fled with his wife and 7 children and came to Walikale in North Kivu.
We were forced to carry each other on our backs like safari ants. The eldest carry the little ones. I carry one, their mother carries the other. The pace isn't the same. That's how I got here.
On March the 3rd, Médecins Sans Frontières published a report denouncing the silent suffering of the Congolese people. The situation in the east of the country is giving even more cause for concern, as the most vulnerable are deprived of the medical care they so desperately need.
As I speak, there are many women victims of rape who are pregnant and are due to give birth. Many come to hospital very late because they stay at home too long, unable to raise enough money for treatment.
MSF's report features medical data and patient and health worker stories assembled during its many years in the region. The organization has called for immediate action to put an end to the suffering of the Congolese people.